sitting here. Guess I didn't make bail. Got time and a story to tell. Started when I was 9 years old. Woke up and daddy was gone. I started hustling and they couldn't tell me nothing. Frontin' in the hood, trying to be somebody. My soul was on empty. I was searching for something. Tried to be good. Tried to keep from trouble. Living too fast. Trying to make good on a hustle. Sometimes it get rough.
Coming from an upfront.
Times got hard.
Hi, my name is Deborah Mello, and welcome to The Reading Room. Today, we're going to be reading from my newest release, 12 Days of Pleasure, the newest installment in the Boudreaux family series. Let's get started. Nodding, Vanessa leaned in closer to his side, and Kendrick wrapped an arm around her shoulders. As they sat in the quiet, he leaned to press a gentle kiss against her forehead, as if it was the easiest, most natural thing he'd done in a very long time. He kissed her a second time as he pulled her closer against him. Vanessa suddenly kicked her legs in the water, splashing them both. "Let's go," she exclaimed, moving on to her feet. Kendrick looked up at her. "Where?" "You still owe me, and I'm ready to collect." He laughed. "You still haven't told me what you're claiming." "I guess you need to get up and come on then," she said, her hands falling against her thin waist. He shook his head. "Now I'm scared," he said, as he lifted his legs out of the pool of water and stood up. As he came to his feet, Vanessa took his hand and pulled him along behind her. She led the way down the stone path toward the beach. The sky above was blue-black, just as the shimmer of moon and twinkling of stars lighting the ground around them. When they reached the edge of the water, she turned toward him, a wide grin across her face. Kendrick eyed her curiously. "What are you up to?" he questioned. "We're going skinny dipping," she said matter-of-factly. Kendrick hesitated for a brief moment. His eyes widened in disbelief. He cocked his head as he stared at her. "I don't think that's a good idea, Miss Harrison." She laughed. "Get your clothes off, chicken. You bet, you lost, I won, and I'm collecting." His head was waving from side to side. "I think we need to talk about this." "Anything I want, isn't that what you said?" He laughed. "I did say that." "Then drop 'em," she said, pointing to his shorts, as she reached for the hem of her tank top and proceeded to pull a garment up and over her head. For more, 12 Days of Pleasure, wherever books are sold. Thank you for being with us once again at The Reading Room. It's been a pleasure.
Sitting here, guess I didn't make bail. Got time and a story to tell. Started when I was 9 years old. Woke up and daddy was gone. I started hustling and they couldn't tell me nothing. Frontin' in the hood, trying to be somebody. My soul was on empty. I was searching for something. Tried to be good. Tried to keep from trouble. Living too fast.